Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our hearts, Lord, are yearning for you to worship you in spirit and in truth. Our hearts, Lord, are yearning, O God, to just glorify and honor you and exalt you and magnify you, Lord. Thank you for everything that you are about to do in our midst. Hallelujah. Happy Appreciation Sunday or month to all the pastors. To all the pastors na makilala ko, to all the pastors in this church, and to all the pastors around the world. We appreciate you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Ang lineup ni Nine, wala na yagin sugid. And, you know, when you are one in the Spirit, something is going to move. Something is going to happen. Hallelujah. Nagapati ka mo sina? Gapati ka mo sina? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So this is Appreciation Sunday. Pastor's Appreciation Sunday. Hallelujah. Madamo sa mga katawhan, kag mga alagad sang Ginoo during this pandemic was taken by the Lord. Ang kuha sila sang Ginoo. Hallelujah. In some other reasons, ang iban, they gave up. Even may naistorya ako nga iban nga mga pastors hindi lamang diri sa Iloilo kundi sa iban pa nga parte sa Pilipinas that nagstruggle gid financially. Hallelujah. Iban naguluntat kada lockdown, nagauntat ang pagpanimbahon ang mga pastor na budlayan gid. Hallelujah. Hindi lang diri kundi sa iban man nga pungsod. Hallelujah. But you see, people of God, the battle that we are fighting, hindi ni aton niya nga pagpakig-away, iya ni sang Ginoo. Ang problema kung kaisa kay ginaako naton ni, that's why we struggle ourselves. But you see, when you know that somebody is behind you, somebody nga nag-back up sa imo, somebody nga balaan mo iya niya nagatubong ka lang iya. Nangin mahapos ang isa kabagay when you know that this battle hindi nagali mo iya niya sa iban. And sa aton bilang mga Kristohanon, ang aton pagpakig-away hindi niya aton. The moment nga tandugon ka sang yawa, masakit man o kung ano man nga mga bagay, ang pagpakig-away hindi na naimo. Kay nga ginapanag-iyahan ka sang Ginoo. Hallelujah. Amen. The moment you give your life to Jesus as your Savior and Lord, ang Ginoo na amuyang imo managapin. Kag kun ikaw ang sa posisyon sang nagaapin, dayon mo na iyahawa siya pay God. Ako ni away na. Palipod. Hindi bala. Ako na niya. So that's what the Lord is telling us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, people of God, I will not be preaching. I'll be teaching this morning. And ini siya nga iwali ko sa inyo is daydayunakon ang kada bersikulo sang 1 Samuel chapter 17 verse 32 up to 50. And I'm going to make some comments about this kag lantaw naton. By the way, this message is entitled Keeping the Sheep. Hallelujah. O tama kalayo no. Lapit man kati Pastor's Appreciation Sunday. Pastors, I would like to encourage you, let's keep on keeping the sheep. Hallelujah. Let us not give up. Let's continue to serve the Lord. All the more nga nabudlayan kita, all the more nga magpalapit kita sa Ginoo. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 32. Let me make some comments here. David said to Saul, let no one lose heart on account of this Philistine. Your servant will go and fight him. Tama, gigka-confident diriya si David. Latawan ninyo ang iya ginhambal. Wala sang halo sang pagduwa-duwa. Wala sang halo sang kung anuman nga klase nga pagduwa-duwa sa iya ginhambal o kung sa iya kaugalingon. Tama, gid siya ka-confident sang iya ginhambal. No? Imagine na bala niya, siling niya, na hindi ka madulaan sa pagsalig, no? Hindi ka madulaan sa pagsalig sa sining mga Pilistino nga ni akong bahala, do grabe, no? Akong magpakigaway sini. Hallelujah. Grabe nga confidence nga ara sa kay David, di niya nahihanging kuha. Balaan ni David kung ano siya. Balaan ni David kung ano ang pwede niya mahimo. People of God, when you are fighting your battle, you should know where you are standing. Kung magpangamuyo ka bala, ari ka bala sa dalom nga nagatangla kag nagapangayo sa Dios, o kung ara ka sa tupad sang Dios. The Bible says that where Jesus is, ara ka manda. So if Jesus is now sitting at the right hand of the throne of God, we are seated with Him. Kung balaan mo, kung diin ka nagaposisyon, kung diin ka nagapayon, nagalain ang imo pagpangamuyo. You see, people of God, when I'm right here, kagang Ginoo at toto, then I'll just be asking and asking so that I can reach out to Him. But when you are sitting beside the Lord, because that's your position, that's where you are, that's where you belong, balaan mo nga ra ka sa tupad sang Ginoo, then nagalain ang imo pagpangayo. Many times, ang aton nga pagpangayo sa Ginoo is pakig-away sa kung anong dapat niya hatag sang Ginoo. Amen? Amen? Kung saan nagpangayo, Lord, gusto kong amo ni Jesus, in Jesus' name, you Satan, hindi pagpailabting akong ginapangayo. But you know that's for you. And you know who you are in Christ. Your asking from the Lord will be different. Lord, I claim it. This is mine. Amen. Amen. I claim it, Lord. This is mine. This is for me. I know this is for me. The enemy cannot take this away from me. There will be no fighting anymore. It's only claiming. Satan, when you take this, it's illegal. I demand recompensation. I demand interest. What belongs to me is mine. And when you take it, that's robbery. Hallelujah. 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 And so David knew what he is. He knew what he was. He knew what he is. And he knew what he can do. That's why he said, "Kalma lang, King Saul. Ako ang magpakig-away." Verse 33, he said, Saul replied, "You are not able to go out against this Philistine and fight him. You are only a young man, and he has been a warrior from his youth." Sounds familiar? Familiar, no? Kung yung magpakig-away, nadumduman ko ang paglakat dito sa mga abangan. When they were praying, Mami Rose dumduman mo, when they were praying, wala ako to actually, this was related to us by Pastor Lanet. When they were praying for the land there, Pastor Lanet was able to see Capri. Kaya ang Capri, you know, Capri was, you know, he has nothing. And he cannot do something against the children of God. So what the Capri did, ginduplaan niya si Pastora. Yun ay mag-away, isang una, mag-away. Mag-away na iya. Tapos kung hindi ka na gani, kadaog, bang dupla ka na lang. Amo na ginahimo, sang kapre. Diba? Amo na. You know, people of God. So, what the devil is doing is intimidation. Look at this. It is a popular type of intimidation. When you are up for something, the devil will try to intimidate you. Because the devil see what is in you, he knows your innate capabilities. Balaan niya kung anong pwede mo mahimo sa iya. Sometimes, ang mga Kristohanon, mas nabalaan pa sang yawa kung anong pwede mahimo sa iya sang sa pwede mahimo sang Kristohanon sa yawa. Mas nakabalo pang yawa sang abilidad sang Kristohanon, ang Kristohanon way kabalo. That's a sad thing. Hallelujah. But you see, lanawan nyo hambaldi, wala man nagbinutig si King Saul, tuod man ang hambal niya, kay bataon man gid si David, silingan na, oh. Notice ninyo, ay saya ka binutig. Silingan, you are not able to go against the Philistine and fight him. You are just a young man. Tutuod man, kagini si Goliath yan, napakigaway na sa iya bugos nga kabuhi, hindi kani kadaog sa iya. Tutakto, no? But you know, sometimes the devil is a master of twisting the truth. He will say the truth, but he will take it for his advantage. Amo na ginimo, yabla kaya Adam and Eve? Ari man tuod ang kamaturan, here's the truth. But he tried to twist it for his advantage. That's what it is. Saul was not lying to, David. He was telling the truth. But Saul highlighted what David cannot do. And the obvious thing. The obvious thing. Gin-highlight niya, gin-spotlight niya, ang ara manggid, ang hayag. David, guwapo ka lang, kagbataon. Iniyahang away na ni halinsang una. You are not able to do it. Kung sa boxing may ara na nga tawag nga tail of the tape. Anong layo, no? Tail of the tape. Magsiling ka nga tail of the tape, pila kabilog ay ang gindaog, amo ni si Pacquiao, amo ni si Barrera, no? So Pacquiao, Barrera, pila kabilog daog ya, pila kabilog daog ya, pila kabilog perdi ya, pila kabilog perdi ya. Ano kung ginag-comparison mo? You're comparing, you are giving statistics. And out of those statistics, Saul deduced. He concluded, David, you are not able to fight for him, to fight him. You will just be defeated out of that statistics. May tail of the tape na, no? So, the tail of the tape will reveal the statistics. In Saul's eyes, there is no way that David can win. But you see, in God's eye, there is no way that David could lose. Sa mata ni Saul, waay gid sang kadalagaan si David. Pero sa mata sang Diyos, hindi pwede maperde si David. Hallelujah! 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 That's the tale of the tape of God. Hallelujah! Many times the enemy would highlight the truth in you and spotlight it as your weakness. He is a master of that. That's why it's really, really a must that you should know the truth so that the truth will really, indeed, set you free. Hallelujah. It's a must, people of God. People of God, hallelujah. Next slide, it says, but David said to Saul, your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off a sheep from the flock, I went after it, struck it, and rescued the sheep from its mouth. When it turned on me, I seized it by its hair, struck it and killed it. Your servant has killed both the lion and the bear. These are circumcised Philistine. Will be like one of them. Ginhimo niya si Goliath nga higanti, nga daw kutitot. Siling niya, ginpatay kong leon. Ginpatay ko man ang uso. Mapariho lang ni siya. You see, that small mustard seed of faith, when you have that, and when you make that work, that small seed of faith that you have, ang gamay nga na, bisan higanti pa, by faith, it will be shrinking down to a smaller entity so that I just can trample it down under my feet. Amen. Hallelujah. That's what faith can do. And that's what David is doing. Hallelujah. Imagine mo, siling niya, my Lord, siya kay Saul, ginpatay kong leon. Siguro nagsugod lang siya sa wolf. No? Apos mo lang wolf, mukha mo malang imustap, tabugon mo. Di ba? But from that small one, then going to lion. Oops, dako-dako na yung leon, kay pwede in-crush ang imong bone. So he overcame the lion. And then, the bear. Imagine the bear, dako-dako na. You see? Isa mo lang ka, muna sang bear sa imo siguro. Bagras na tanan ng imo ng mga unod. Ubus na. Si people of God, it's a pattern. Makita mong pattern na halin sa gamay pakadto sa mga dalag ko. Do not despise your small beginnings. Do not despise those small things that you have created, those small victories that you have surmounted. Hindi pagpabayi ngay ng mga gagmay ng mga bagay nga imo na lapawan kag imo na sapawan kag imo na overcome sa kabuhi mo. Hindi na walay pulos mga kauturan pagagamiton ina sang Ginoo agun nga do kaangang isang hagdanan magasaka ka amo nang ginahambal naton from faith to faith, from glory to glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ang imo experience sang gintago ka dito sa may COVID facility ni Lyra. Hallelujah. Sang dito ka, ang imo nga experience sang anxiety, ang imo express, ang imo nga depression nga somehow nag-creep in sa imo, somehow I can relate to that. Makita ko man sila bilong adlaw pro kung gingkit ka sa sulod sang kwarto, I tell you, if not for God, if not with God, hallelujah, people will just simply succumb to depression, succumb to anxiety, and it's very, very dangerous thing. Hallelujah. I tell you, people of God. So, you see, generally, oh, by the way, a lion attacked the lambs, and David fought the lion. A bear came against the sheep, and David battled the bear. All along, God prepared David to fight Goliath. Kita nyo? Halin sa wolf, pakadto sa leon, pakadto sa bear, and this time, giant. You cannot conquer your giant if you cannot conquer your wolf, if you cannot conquer your lion, if you cannot conquer your bear. People of God, eventually, God will present to you something that you cannot overcome. The Bible says, wala sang may ihatag sa imo ang Ginoo nga hindi mo masarangan. Tanan nga mga pagtilaw, tanan nga mga kabudlayan, ginhatag ra sa imo tungod masarangan muna. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Wala sang tawo nga may nga masubra pa dira. Biskan ang ara sa mga Bible gintistingan man. Ara sila tanan nakita mong pattern. Kita mong pattern, mga kakauturan, nga halin sa gagmay hasta sa dalag ko. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Probably, amuna na siling ko, may wolf, the son lion, may bear, then here comes the giant. Hindi mo na paghatag sa imo sang Ginoo ang higante, kundi mo na masarangan. Amen? Hindi na paghatag sa imo. Hallelujah. It's just a training. It's just a training. It's a stepping stone, one after another. Young as you are, there might be a painful experience in your life. Dreadful. May makahalanguyos kang experience sa imo kabuhi. Ginatago-tago mo. Nagaut-ut sang imo personalidad. Nagaut-ut sang imo emosyon. Nagaut-ut sang imo paminsaron. Ngay na gani kung kaisa ginadamgo mo mga butang nga pilit mo kalipatan. Butang nga mga eksperyensya mo ang pagbuyayaw sa imo ni tatay mo. Natubang mo gid damo tawo na huyan ka gid. Ginabuli ka sa mga classmates mo. Tama kasakit. Biskan sa imo katulugon bitbit mo ni. Ginabangungot ka. People of God, no matter what, people of God, how dreadful it is, how dark your experience it, people of God, you may even have an unwholesome experience sa imong eskwelahan, kundiin man nga imong experience. But without knowing it, God has been training you all along. Ginatrain ka lang sang Ginoo. Hallelujah. God calls for your faithfulness in the training. If you give up, Sa wolf palangadaan, nag-give up ka na, you cannot conquer your giant. Kung sa lion palang nag-give up ka na, you cannot conquer your giant. Or even, nag-give up ka sa imong bear, hindi kagit kalambot sa imong giant. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Remember that it is in conquering Goliath that David had a mark in the history of Israel. Dito siya nakilala. Paano siya makilala sa una kay Atot Siyega Panago sa may waya? Ang upod niya lang dito, amo ang mga karniro. Wala, sa iban nga upod. Karniro po dya. Sinusturyahon niya to. Wala, karniro lang. Te, basigan ni Kuro Kabalo na to mag-istorya si David sa mga karniro. Me, baram you. But you see, people of God, ang tanan nga ini calls for faithfulness. If you are faithful in small things, God cannot promote you in bigger things. If you're not faithful in your wolf, God cannot promote you in your lion. If you're not faithful in your lion, God cannot promote you in your bear. Hallelujah. So be faithful. Sa mga pastor man, pastor, it calls for faithfulness. Let us not give up in doing good, for in the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we will not give up. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Verse 38 to 40, it says, when Saul dressed David in his own tunic, he put a coat of armor on him and a bronze helmet on his head. David fastened on his sword over the tunic and tried walking around because he was not used to them. I cannot go in this, he said to Saul, because I am not used to them. So he took them off. Then he took his staff in his hand, chose 5 smooth stones from the stream, put them in the pouch of his shepherd's bag, and with his sling in his hand, approached the Philistines. Look at this. Ginpaulam siya ni Saul sang iya armor. Pero kung natabuan nga si King Saul kag si King David pariyong lawas, kag ginsuksok ni King ni David ang armor ni Saul, tindihan niya mo ko silingon, ginpaulam sa kung pariyo sila lawas, suksok niya, suited ged, okay ged, paggwa niya, ang makita dito, hindi si David, kundi si King Saul. Amen. Amen. Tindihan niyo? You don't have to wear anyone else's armor. Kung kisa ilog-ilog kita sang style sang iban nga mga ministers, ilog-ilog man kita sang ilang way sa pag-minister, ilog-ilog man kita sang ilang way sang ilang pag-pray, the way they declare, the way they preach, the way they speak, the way they talk, we follow them. We emulate them. People of God, we don't have to follow their, we don't have to wear their own armor. You don't have to be somebody else in order to win the battle. Kay nakita naton, nga nangin madinilagon sa kay ginamuyan eh, ginailog-ilog man naton. No! Each and every one of us has his own battle to win and to conquer. And God has given you your own weapon. Hallelujah. So ginuuban ni David ang armor ni King Saul. Anong nabilin sa iya? Ang iya bayo, ang iyang staff, ang iyang sling. Kag nagkuha sang 5 kamahining mapino nga mga bato dito sa may sapa. Dito siya nagkuha nga mapino nga bato. You see, ining mga bato nga ni naghalin ini dito sa babaw sang bukid, nagligid-ligid tugod sang ginanod sang tubi. Tungon nga nagligid-ligid, nagsagad kiski sa iban nga mga bato, paglambot siya sa gibuangan, pino na siya. Amo ni siya ang makapatay sa imo Goliath. Amo ni siya ang bala. Amo ni siya ang armas nga makapatay sa imo nga Goliath. The purity. May finis blang ang itawag, ang character nga ginpino sang Ginoo. Amo ni siya ang bala naton sa aton nga weapon, people of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amo na mga kauturan, kung gisa, ilog-ilog naton ganin si Pastor Leonard kung paano mag-pray. Okay lang na, gailog-ilog kita. Sometimes, wala ko nagambal nga sala niya. Okay na nga ginailog nun siya because you learn from them. You learn from us. Okay na nga ginailog nyo, but you have to make your own style. You have to make your own identity. Long before I tried to emulate Gary Valenciano on how to sing, I tried to emulate Chris Christian on how to sing. Those good Christian singers, I tried to follow their ways. But later on, I find that if I tried to follow them, later on, I will not be me. I will lose my identity if I keep on following them. When I play the instrument, I have to do this because I want to be like him. Look at that. I tried always to counsel Judd. Judd, you don't have to follow everything. You don't have to follow them. Create your own so that when you have your own, you will have your own identity. You will have your own ambience when you begin to play your instruments. That's what it is when you pray. And it is out of your experience. Kung nagapangamuyo ka, kagangi mo pagpakigbato tungod sa imo mga eksperyensya sa pamatian sang iban, tama gini ka-experyensyado nga tao ka, ekspektibo sang iya pagpangamuyo. You are building your own. Hindi mo kinanglan nga isuklob ang armor ni Pastor Alianet. Hindi mo kinanglan isuklob ang armor ni Pastor Ron sa pag-lead sa praise and worship. Hindi mo kinanglan nga isuklob ang armor ni Pastor Ming sa pagwali. You can have your own. And with that, you as you are, you can win your battle. Hallelujah. 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 Ining mga gagmay nga mga bagay, ang mga kabalpakan mo sang una, halin sang imo gamay. Ang tanan nimo nga mga dark moments, mga dark secrets mo sang una sang gamay mo pa, sang teenager mo, those things. What am I talking about? What I mean is your mess can become your message. Your test can be your testimony. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. People of God, i-allow lang niya si Lord nga magbaniubra si imo kabuhi. Ha, soon you will realize that what you have, the real you, just as you are, is the best weapon there is that God can ever use through you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The best weapon you could ever have is what you have been trained by God. Ang imo experience na, ang gugma-gugma mo na nga napalpa ka sa pagigugma mo, kag nag-learn ka, pwede mo na sa uli i-counsel, utod, hindi ka satisfy ang magpakigrelasyon sa early nga age. Hindi ka ngayon, hindi pa kasarang ang imo emosyon sa pagbaton, mahimo nga masuicide ka lang kundi mo ni mabaton. Pero kung hulaton mo ngang imo emotion, mangin mature ka, kapin pa nga magpakig, saad ka sa Ginoo, mangin mature ka, time will come when you have a relationship, you are able to handle it. Hallelujah. People of God, the best weapon you could ever have is what you have been trained by God. Hallelujah. Amuin na mga kauturan. Hallelujah. Meanwhile, the Philistine was with his shield bearer in front of him, kept coming closer to David. He looked David over and saw that he was little more than a boy, glowing with health and handsome, and he despised him. And he said to David, "Am I a dog that you come at me with sticks?" And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. "Come here," he said, "and I'll give your flesh to the birds and the wild animals." This is a classic spiritual warfare. Hallelujah. Kung ikaw nagapakigaaway, ang iyawa lang tawo niya na kundi nang manaayo ka. Kag kung anong manami si mo, i-despise niya na. I-put down ka sang iyawa. Hallelujah. I-put down ka sang iyawa. I-discredit ka sang iyawa. I-humiliate ka sang iyawa. Kag mag-hurl siya sang mga intimidation. Tanan, deception. Tanan, i-hurl. I-haboy si mo sang iyawa. But si David wala nagpamati sa kung anuman ginambal ni ni Goliath. Lantawan niyo sa next slide. And I'm about to end. David said to the Philistine, "You come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will deliver you in my hands." It is a declaration. It is, there is certainty. There is firmness in it. Hallelujah. "And I'll strike you down and cut off your head." Hallelujah. "This very day I will give the carcasses of the Philistines' army to the birds and the wild animals, and the whole world will know that there is God in Israel. And those gathered here will know it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves. For the battle is the Lord's." The battle is the Lord's. Hindi pagakuka akua ang imo nga kabudlayan. Hindi pagakakuha ang imo nga poverty. Ang pagpakigaway mo sa kaimulon, hindi pagkakuha. Kaya ang pagpakigaway nga na, hindi mo iyasang Ginoo. Hindi pagkakuha ang pagpakigaway sa imo masakit. Kaya ang pagpakigaway nga na, hindi na imo iyasang Ginoo. Ang pagpakigaway sa nagalibak, ang pagpakigaway sa itong mga tao nga nag-put down sa imo, hindi na siya imo iyasang Ginoo. The moment you step into covenant with God, God is backing you up. He will take the reign of the war from you. You don't have to struggle. You don't have to fight your own war, because the battle is the Lord's. Hallelujah. 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 And lastly, people of God, diin ni ang confidence ni David nagalin. Diin ni siya nagalin. It is in keeping the sheep. Diin naghalin ang iya kasagad sa paghabyog sang iya nga tirador. It was in keeping the sheep. Samtang nagabatay siya sa mga karniro, way siya sang ibang obrahon. Naghimo siya sang sling. Nagtisting-tisting. Nakita ayang bunga sang ulibo. Pagkauli, gintistingan niya haboy. Sa dalayo niya ng haboy-haboy, nangin sagad siya sa paggamit sang iya nga labyo. Hallelujah. It was in keeping the sheep. It was in keeping the sheep that he became close to God. Wala sa sang ibang istoryahon. Hindi man siya kaistorya sa iya mga karniro. And right there, in the middle of the night, he will see the creation of God. And he began to appreciate the presence of God in his life. Where did he get the confidence? It is in keeping the sheep. Hallelujah! It is in keeping the sheep. It was in keeping the sheep that he honed his skills to fight in order to protect the sheep. He had to trust God in order to protect them. His years in keeping the sheep is not his waiting time. It was a training time. Hallelujah! He developed the shepherd's heart because he allowed God to shepherd him. And when he said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures." People of God, it was in keeping the sheep. He was there making psalms and songs while keeping the sheep. Your keeping the sheep means the lowest point of your life. When the time that nobody acknowledges you, when the time that nobody acknowledge your work, that would be the time in which you are keeping the sheep. But you see, it is your training time. It is your promotion time. It is where God will put His heart in you. Hallelujah. Nangin sa God si David sa pagtatap sa bilog ng Israel, nagsugod siya sa pagtatap sa mga karniro. It was in keeping the sheep. Do not despise your humble beginning. Do not despise your hurtful past, your painful past, your dark past. Do not despise them. It is where God has been training you. It was in keeping the sheep that David saw and had his victory. Amo man ang pagahimoon sa inyo sang Ginoo, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen and Amen.